Now we are going to see about the concept of biodiversity. Bio means life, diversity means different. So coming to the introduction, the term biodiversity was introduced by an American biologist, Edward Wilson. Biodiversity refers to variety of life forms and habitats found in a defined area. It represents the totality of species, genes and ecosystem in a given region. Next, levels of biodiversity. So the biological diversity includes three interrelated hierarchical level. First, it is genetical diversity. Next, it is species diversity. Again, it is ecological diversity. Coming to the genetical diversity. So the genetic variation existing within the species, we call it as genetic diversity. Even though we are humans, we genetically have many different forms because of we have n number of genes. So the variations may be in alleles, total genes or chromosomal structure. The number of genes are in follows. For example, mycoplasma has 450 to 700 genes. Escherichia coli, which is around 4000. Drosophila melanogaster, which is around 13,000. Oryza sativa, 32,000 to 50,000. Homo sapiens, 35,000 to 45,000 number of genes are there. Next, species diversity. The diversity at the species level, we call it as species diversity. For example, Western Ghats have the greater amphibian species diversity than the Eastern Ghats. The species diversity depends upon the number and richness of the species of that region. Species richness is nothing but the number of species per the unit area. Next, ecological diversity. The diversity at the ecosystem level, we call it as ecological diversity. For example, deserts, rainforest, mangroves, coral reef, wetlands, estuary and alpine meadows, etc. In this picture, we can able to see the rainforest, for example, Amazon rainforest. Mangrove, it is nothing but a group of trees and shrubs together has been aggregated in between the tidal area and estuary. So these are like grasslands and coral reefs, which is present under the sea. Next, global species diversity. According to IUCN 2004 report, the total number of plants and animal species are more than 1.5 million. Robert May estimated that the global species diversity is at about 7 million. More than 70% of all the species are recorded are animals and plants, including algae, fungi, bryophytes, gymnosperms and angiosperms, comprise about 22% of total. Next, among the animals, the insects are making about more than 70% of the total. Out of every 10 animals on this planet, 7 are insects. So the number of fungi species in the world is more than the combined total of the species of fishes, amphibians, reptiles and mammals. India has only 2.4% of the world's land area, but shares around 8.1% of global species diversity. India is one of the 12 mega diversity countries of the world. So in this picture, we can able to see the pie charts of invertebrates, vertebrates and plants. First, invertebrates. The major portion is being occupied by insects. The remaining is for mollusks, crustaceans and other animal groups. Coming to the vertebrates, half of the thing is being occupied by fishes. Remaining is for mammals, birds, reptiles and amphibians. Coming to the plants, so the major portion is for fungi and angiosperms. Remaining is for mosses, ferns, algae and lichens. Next, pattern of biodiversity. The biodiversity is not uniform throughout the world, but shows uneven distribution. The biodiversity is being affected by two factors: latitudinal gradient or species area relationship. First, latitudinal gradient. In general, species diversity decreases as we move away from the equator towards the poles. Few exceptions are there for this also: tropics. So the latitudinal range of 23.5 degrees north to 23.5 degrees south so harbors more species than the temperate or polar areas. Especially here we have an exception. Colombia, located near the equator, has nearly 1400 species of birds, while the New York at 41 degrees north has 105 species, and Greenland at 71 degrees north only has 56 species. India, with much of its land area in the tropical latitude, has more than 1200 species of birds. Next, so this is an example. We have the Amazon rainforest. So the large tropical Amazonian rainforest in South America has the greatest biodiversity on Earth. So it is the home to more than 40,000 species of plants, 3,000 of fishes, 1,300 of birds, 427 of mammals and again 427 of amphibians, 378 of reptiles and more than 125,000 of invertebrates. Coming to the greater biodiversity in tropics, because the various hypotheses for higher diversity in tropics proposed by ecologists and evolutionary biologists are: the temperate regions has undergo further glaciations in the past. It killed most of the species. The tropical latitude have remained relatively undisturbed for millions of years. So the tropical environment are less seasonal, which promote niche specialization and lead to greater species diversity. So more solar energy is available in the tropics, which contributes to higher productivity and in turn might contribute indirectly to greater diversity. Next, species area relationship. Alexander von Humboldt was the German naturalist and explorer. He observed that within an area, species richness will increase by increasing the explored area, but only up to a limit. The relationship between the species richness and the area for wide variety of taxa is a rectangular hyperbola. So, on a logarithmic scale, the relationship is a straight line described by an equation, which is log S is equal to log C plus Z log A, where S is the species richness, A is equal to area, Z will denote the slope of line, regression coefficient, C is equal to Y intercept. Coming to importance of species diversity to the ecosystem, to maintain the stability, to improve the productivity and for ecosystem health. Coming to the loss of biodiversity, due to the human activities, biological resources have been declining rapidly. The colonization of tropical Pacific islands by humans lead to extinction of more than 2,000 species of native birds. More than 15,500 species are facing the threat of extinction in the worldwide. At present, 12% of birds, 23% of mammals, 32% of amphibians and 31% of gymnosperms face the threat of extinction. Recently extinct animals are dodo, quagga, so dodo in Mauritius, quagga in Africa, Stella sea cow in Russia and thylacine in Australia, or Tasmanian tiger we also call it as. Mass extinction. Due to the natural calamities, a large number of species become extinct, which we call it as mass extinction. Since the origin and diversification of life on Earth, there are 5 episodes of mass extinction of species. The big 5 mass extinction are of follows: End Ordovician, Late Devonian, End Permian, End Triassic, or End Cretaceous, are the 5 big mass extinctions. And the 6th extinction is presently in progress, which is different from the previous episodes. The current species extinction rates are to be 100 to 1000 times faster than the pre-human times, and human activities are responsible for the faster rates. So the ecologist warns that if the present trend continues, nearly half of all the species on Earth might be wiped out within the next 100 years. Coming to the effect of biodiversity loss, so decline in the plant production, lowered the resistance to environmental perturbations such as drought, increasing in the variability in certain ecosystem process such as plant productivity, water use, pest and disease cycles. Coming to the causes of biodiversity loss, habitat loss and fragmentation, overexploitation, alien species invasions, co-extinctions. First, habitat loss and fragmentation. Destruction of habitat is the primary cause of extinction of species. The tropical rainforest initially covered 14% of the land, but now it is only 6%. The Amazon rainforest, we call it as lungs of the planet. When large-sized habitats are broken into a smaller fragments due to human activities, certain animals are badly affected and threatens their survival. Coming to overexploitation, when natural resources are overexploited by the humans due to his greed, it results the degradation and extinction of resources. For example, Stellar sea cows, passenger pigeons are being extinct on this case. Coming to alien species invasion. So the introduction of Nile perch into the Lake Victoria led to extinction of more than 200 species of indigenous chichelled fish. Coming to the recently illegal introduction of African catfish, Clarias, is poisoning the threat of indigenous catfishes of India. Next, coming to alien weeds. This carrot grass, lantana and water hyacinth in West Bengal is being seen because of this huge alien weeds. Co-extinctions. When the species become extinct, the plant and the animal species associated with it in an obligatory manner also become extinct. For example, if the host fishes become extinct, all those parasites exclusively found will also will become extinct. Coming to reasons for biodiversity, narrowly utilitarian, broadly utilitarian, and ethical argument. Coming to the narrowly utilitarian, the economical benefit for nature is because of food, firewood, fiber, medicine, construction, and industrial products. So we have to utilize it based on our need, not too much exploration. Next, broadly utilitarian, ecosystem services such as Amazon forest produces around 20% of total oxygen in the atmosphere on the earth. So the pollination of plants through pollinators by bees, birds, and bats, or aesthetic pleasures of walking through the thick woods and watching, so spring flowers, etc. Coming to ethical argument, there are millions of plants and animals and microbes on the earth with whom we share. So each species on the earth has their some intrinsic value. It is therefore our moral duty to take care of all the living creatures and pass on our biological legacy in good order for our future generations. Coming to in situ and ex situ conservation. In situ conservation. Conservation and protection of whole ecosystem, protection of its biodiversity at all the levels. Biosphere reserves, national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, and scared groves. Coming to ex situ conservation. Protection of animals or plants when they are in endangered or threatened or need urgent measures to save their extinction. Zoological parks, botanical gardens, and wildlife safaris. Conventions on Biodiversity. The 8th Summit held in Rio de Janeiro in 1992. The World Summit is on Sustainable Development held in Johannesburg in South Africa in 2002. In this summit, so 190 countries pledged their commitment to reduce the current rate of biodiversity loss at global, regional, and local levels by 2010. Okay, thank you very much. Please do like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel.